Guys, we are back in Forza Horizon 2, and we got ourselves the brand new free Mazda MX-5 car pack that just got released today on Forza Horizon 2, and we are taking out the 2010 Mazda MX-5 Super 20. This car is insane. It's in the track toy class, and wow, it is one of the best track toys in the game. I absolutely love this car. So I got this set up at an S1 900 class right on the dot with 380 horsepower, twin screw supercharged at 290 pounds of torque, weighing only at 2,133 pounds. Wow, this thing is a lightweight. And honestly, guys, you know, I really want to make a high S1 class for this car. And honestly, any higher, it's going to be so hard to control. Even at the point that it's at right now, I am seriously, and I mean, I am seriously contemplating whether to reduce the power that I have in this thing. This thing starts out about at 225 horsepower stock. Now, I upgraded it to about 380 on the dot. And honestly, this thing can barely manage 380 horsepower. It is so light, and with it being rear-wheel drive, it's pushing it, guys. It is so close to being almost impossible to control. It is unbelievable. You'll see me, like, I'm not trying to drift. Believe me, there's race tires on this thing. I do not want to drift this thing. This is supposed to be a race car in the track toy class, and I'm like sliding all over the place. It is super, super, super hard to keep straight, guys. This thing wants to go sideways. I am constantly fighting with this thing, and I mean, if I reduce the power a little bit, it will definitely help, but I wanted to make this right on the dot S1 900 to really give it the full potential. And it's one of the drawbacks that you may have to deal with, is just being able to just know that, whoa, every turn I'm taking, you know, this thing might bite at me, so I'm gonna have to be ready for it. And that's pretty much the approach you gotta take with this Miata. And I mean, I expected that. With coming into it, I knew that this car would do that to me. All of them do that to me, even the RX-7, which has even a little bit more weight to this. It still does it to me. They all do it. You guys know that. So I'm just giving you guys a fair warning. But besides that, this thing is absolutely just amazing. I love it. Super fast. The handling is amazing. Like, I can take turns, like really sharp turns, and almost, or two, like over 100 miles per hour. It is insane. I was just taking out the M4 earlier. I know I can't do it. I was trying to do it. I was going off the road at like 70 miles per hour. This thing has way better handling than most cars, and it should. You know, it's super light, super small, and that's one of the positives about this car. So if you are looking to race, definitely, 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 it's great, especially for short circuits with lots of turns. This is one car that I would definitely choose over many. Now, I mean, this isn't, you know, there's obviously other track toys you could choose from, like the S2000, you know, other Miatas, but this one alone is an amazing, amazing car. So if I were to choose out of the MX-5s, I would definitely go with this one as my track toy class car to use. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but I did some research on this car, and this car is probably the rarest car, or one of the rarest cars in the world. You guys probably don't know that. I didn't know that. I thought this car was, you know, for sale back in 2010, but apparently it wasn't. There's only one car on the universe that has this car, and that's probably Mazda. No one owns this car. Car and Driver did a review on it, but I don't think they own it. It never got sold. But that's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think. Make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe.